former presidential candidate, Senator Bernie Sanders, has just endorsed Joe Biden for the Democratic nomination. Happened moments ago as Sanders joined his former campaign rival on Biden's live stream.
My friend, Senator Bernie Sanders. Bernie, welcome.
Joe, thank you very much for your remarks, and thank you for welcoming me to your live stream here. As you've indicated, we are living in an unbelievably unprecedented moment. You and I were chatting a few months ago, not in a million years would we have believed that we would be talking to each other in our respective homes, that we could not, you know, do rallies, that we could not get out of the house. We would not have believed that we'd be looking not only at a pandemic, which, as you indicated, has taken over 20,000 lives in our country, 500,000 people infected, but has cost us 16 million jobs. And that's probably a conservative number. The real number is probably higher than that. So we are in a terrible moment, an unprecedented moment. And I know we share the understanding that we've got to go forward right now and out of this in an unprecedented way to address the terrible pain that so many of our fellow Americans are feeling. So today I am asking all Americans, I'm asking every Democrat, I'm asking every independent, I'm asking a lot of Republicans to come together in this campaign to support your candidacy, which I endorse, to make certain that we defeat somebody who I believe, and I'm speaking just for myself now, is the most dangerous president in the modern history of this country, a president, and you made this point, who downplayed this pandemic, who ignored the advice that some of his people were giving him, who has not used the Defense Production Act early on so that we could produce the masks, the gowns, the gloves, the ventilators that our medical personnel desperately need, who today, because I understand that is threatening to fire Dr. Fauci, who has been unbelievable. I mean, it is, who has been day after day the voice of science to the American people, trying to explain how we go forward in this crisis, and he's threatening to fire him. So to me, for all of those reasons and so many more, a president who doesn't, apparently has never read the Constitution of the United States, who believes he's above the law, a president who lies all of the time, a president who has at least shown me that he is a racist and a sexist and a homophobe and a xenophobe and a religious bigot. I mean, for all of those reasons or more, we've got to make Trump a one-term president, and we need you in the White House. So I will do all that I can to see that that happens, Joe. And I know that there is an enormous responsibility on your shoulders right now. It's imperative that all of us work together to do what has to be done, not only in this moment, but beyond this moment, in the future of this country. And in that regard, I have been very pleased that your staff and my staff have been working together over the last several weeks to coming up with a number of task forces. These are task forces that will look at some of the most important issues facing this country, the economy, how we create an economy that works for all, not just a few, education, how we create the best educational system in the world for all of our people, how we deal with climate change, which, as you indicated, is an existential threat to the planet, how we deal with criminal justice, because we don't want to continue having more people in jail than any other country on earth, how we deal with immigration reform, how we have a healthcare system that is so much better than what we have right now. Now, it's no great secret out there, Joe, that you and I have our differences, and we're not going to paper them over. That's real. But I hope that these task forces will come together utilizing the best minds and people in your campaign and in my campaign to work out real solutions to these very, very important problems. So look forward to working with you and bringing some great people into those task forces.
Well, Bernie, I want to thank you for that. It's a big deal. I think that your endorsement means a great deal. It means a great deal to me. I think people are going to be surprised that we are apart on some issues, but we're awfully close on a whole bunch of others. And I think you've made, if I am the nominee, which it looks like now you just made me, I'm going to need you, not just to win the campaign, but to govern.
I want to bring in Chief Political Analyst Gloria Borger and CNN's Jessica Dean. Jessica, it comes less than a week after Sanders bowed out of the race.
Yeah, Anderson, this moved pretty quickly. We're about 5 days after Bernie Sanders officially exited the race and suspended his campaign. And you just saw the video there. That visual of Bernie Sanders and Joe Biden together on the live stream really showing the Democratic Party, both sides of it, unifying. That is something the Biden campaign was really hoping to see and has been very, very important for them. They have really treated this delicately, as the Sanders campaign and the Biden campaign have been talking now for a while about how to make this happen. For days now, my colleague Ryan Noble's reporting that this was really born out of them coming together and talking about the coronavirus, that they decided to form these task force, which they announced today, that Sanders and Biden will be working on 6 key issues moving forward, putting policies together. That includes the economy, education, health care, criminal justice, climate change, and immigration. So really showing the Democratic Party this united front. Bernie Sanders giving his full endorsement, which you'll remember he didn't do 5 days ago when he got out of the race. And then really talking about issues where they can find common ground, Anderson, things like the $15 minimum wage and student debt forgiveness.
Gloria, why do you think Senator Sanders waited a week to officially endorse?
Well, I think when he originally got out of the race, he felt a responsibility to talk to his supporters, first and foremost, because they've been working for him for years, are dedicated to him personally, as well as politically. And I think that if he had just jumped out and said, oh, and by the way, I'm endorsing Joe Biden, who many of them, by the way, Anderson, are still saying they refuse to support, I think it would have been received badly. I think what we saw today, as Jessica points out, was well choreographed. There are clearly some issues that they're going to agree on at the outset, like the $15 minimum wage. Establishing a task force is what Bernie Sanders wants. You can be sure that lots of the things that Bernie Sanders wants are going to be in the Democratic platform. And I think they wanted to show that they are working together and not against each other. This is very different from the way it was with Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders. I think that Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders like each other personally. And I think so the transition, in a way, has been a lot easier.
And yet, Jessica Dean, Bernie Sanders, when he initially announced, he said that that he will be remaining on the ballot, wanting to gain as much many delegates as possible in order to have more power at the conventions. I assume that's still the case.
Right. Right, and that appears to still be the case. Of course, he wanted to have as big a voice as possible when it gets to the convention to be able to really affect the party's platform. But Anderson, as you heard them talking about today, it sounds like they're laying a lot of that out right now as well. Bernie Sanders certainly is a force within the Democratic Party, has a lot of leverage, and the Biden campaign seems to be listening to him and trying to find a lot of this common ground that they can unite on.
Yeah, Jessica Dean, Gloria Borger, thanks very much. Appreciate it. Oh, sorry. Go ahead, Gloria.
Well, I was going to say, in the age of coronavirus, I think a lot of this has changed. I think that Bernie Sanders, and he said it over and over again, has said that the main job is to beat Donald Trump, and they have to do it together. And I think they're going to be talking a lot about his leadership during this virus.